Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 17 offered hundreds of new features and changes. While none were gigantic changes for the most part, there's quite a few that maybe you either missed or already forgot, but you shouldn't because they're super helpful. Now the first one is on the home screen. We probably all know how to move apps and multiple apps at once, but maybe if we go to this page here and we'll press and hold, we've got it highlighted. Just tap another one if you want to get rid of it and move it off the screen. You can do that simply just by tapping, then you can move it around to wherever you'd like. However, if you want to remove them from your home screen all at once, drag them to the right until you get to the app library and let go. Now they disappear and they're gone forever, and you can add them later, but that way you can remove multiple apps at once. So I think that's something that's super helpful for most people if you weren't aware. The next thing has to do with the camera and with photos. Apple added a lot of AI-based features to help you understand different labels around the world. And if you're using your camera and maybe you take a photo of a piece of clothing and you want to know what those symbols are, it will actually tell you. So go ahead and take a picture of clothing or the little label there, and then you'll see the eye in your photos with the little star. Tap on it and it will actually say, "Look up laundry care." Tap on that and tap continue if you've never used it, and then it will tell you exactly what it is. Washing, normal process, maximum 30 Celsius. So you've got a bunch of different ones here explaining all of the labels that are on the current label you're viewing. This is also true for things such as car gauges. So this is after turning my car on. Of course, it shows all the lights right away until you start it. But if you want to understand what those auto symbols are, you'll see here, this one says steering failure. So if I actually had that when I started the car, I would need to maybe bring it to a mechanic or something else. So it will let you know all of the different things on the display, along with whatever else you might have. You can sort of zoom into those things and it will let you know. Also, it will let you know about birds, as well as cats and dogs. So if you tap on it here, you can see there's a little label for a dog, what type it is. Again, for a cat here, it will look that up. And another thing is for music as well. So you can use it for music and even food to find out recipes. So if you want to learn how to make this donut here, you've got a quick recipe for it that it will find based off the image you're sharing. So that's something that I think super helpful that may have been overlooked. Now on your home screen, if you're someone that likes to change your wallpaper a lot, or maybe just set different home screens based on your location, that's something you can do with focus modes that many people forgot. So for example, if we press and hold and then you tap the dots, we have multiple home screens, but maybe we want to change that based on our location. Go into your settings, and then under focus, within focus, we can set up a new one. So maybe we'll set up this focus. We'll set up a custom one. We can name our focus, new focus. And then maybe we'll make it blue, tap next, tap customize. Now we can set it for different people, apps, or locations. We can choose our background or lock screen. So maybe we have a different one set. You can see all of them here. Maybe this time around, I want this one. Then we'll tap done. Then we can choose the same for our watch face. So maybe we want to change it to Snoopy when we're home or something else. And also we can change our home screen as well. I want just this one and this one, but not my main home screen when I'm home. And then when I enable this focus mode or set it based on a schedule, I can have it activate based on where I am, smart activation. And you'll see it says automatically turns new focus on at relevant times throughout the day based on signals like your location, app usage, and more. So for example, if I add a filter, I can filter it by using music or Safari or something else, and it will enable it. So now if I go into focus modes and maybe I enable the new focus, you'll see my wallpaper just instantly changed. I don't have my main wallpaper here or my main screen anymore with my widgets. I just have the two that I selected. If I go back in, switch to do not disturb, it changes my wallpaper and lock screen back. And then I have all of my pages just like before. It also changes the watch. So if I switch this maybe over to new focus, give it a second, it should switch on my watch. There it is, to Snoopy. And then again, back to do not disturb, give it a second, it switches back to what I was using before. Super helpful. And if you like to change that up a lot, it makes it really easy to do that. Now, one thing that's really helpful that Apple added has to do with your passcode. Go into your settings and maybe you just changed your passcode. So Face ID and passcode, put in your passcode you currently have. Then if we go ahead and change our passcode, we'll put in our current one. We'll put in a new one. We'll just do 654321 and we'll use it anyway. Just for this demonstration, we'll change it. Once it's changed, give it a moment here, and now you'll have an option to temporarily use your previous passcode. So maybe you forgot the one you just changed and you need to use it. You can expire it now, so you can't use it, but you can use it for up to 72 hours. So if I lock the display and then I go to unlock it, when you get to the point where your passcode doesn't work, you don't remember it, you can tap on forgot passcode. Tap on it here and it says enter previous passcode. Enter the previous passcode, then it unlocks and it says enter your new passcode. So maybe we want to create another one. Then you can create a new one. This is just 123456 and you're ready to go. But if you need to manage multiple passwords like I do, maybe you have thousands of them, today's sponsor NordPass helps keep your password secure for both personal use and business use as well. If we go into NordPass, and then under our tools, we have a password generator, of course, where we can create secure passcodes based on length, use capital letters, use digits, use symbols, maybe words or whatever you'd like. You can customize this to whatever you'd like here. And of course, use that across different devices. I have thousands of passwords and I don't like keeping everything under one company, such as maybe Apple or Google. NordPass easily lets you import or export passwords and easily fill in your passwords in your browsers or apps. If we go to a website, then if I go to sign into my Nord account, it recognizes my login and allows me to fill in the password. Just tap on it. It uses Face ID and then I can log in. Super simple, just like you were using iCloud Keychain. Not only can you easily generate passwords, but NordPass Premium checks your password health to make sure no passwords are at risk and even alerts you if maybe there's a data breach as well. You can search for that and scan through all of your passcodes to make sure there isn't any, as well as password health and things such as weak passwords, reused, or old passwords that are due to expire or need to be changed. With NordPass, you can also use passkeys and share those across all of your devices and with colleagues as well. If you're a business owner or startup or simply have a team, go to nordpass.com/zollotech and get a free 3-month business trial with the activation code zollotech. Be sure to check it out in the description. Another feature that's super helpful is maybe you're on a website and you don't have time to read the article, or maybe you have trouble seeing it. If the article actually supports it, you can listen to the page in your audio player and it will read it to you.
Morning, Fuzzy Feelings Holiday Ad. Julie Clover. Tuesday, November 21st, 2023, 9:18 a.m. PST. Apple today shared its annual holiday themed ad, which is titled...
You can see it in your music player and it will just read the whole article to you. I think that's super convenient. Now, maybe you're on a website and you're sick of those GIFs or GIFs autoplaying. You don't want to see all of that flashing all at once. You can actually disable this in your settings. Go to accessibility, then go to motion. Under motion, you have autoplay animated images. If you disable this, you can actually stop all those GIFs or GIFs from actually animating and maybe even using more resources or battery power. So if you want to disable that, the option's there. If you don't, just leave it on. Years ago with the iPhone 6, Apple introduced a new feature called 3D Touch. You could press and hold on a different application and get a submenu, sort of like right-clicking. However, they replaced this with Haptic Touch and it works just by pressing on the display for a set amount of time, but it doesn't work as well. And if you want to make it feel much more like 3D Touch, there's an option to do that now. Go into your settings, scroll down to accessibility, then go to touch, then go to haptic touch and switch this to fast. It makes it feel and respond just like it's with 3D touch. So with default, you'll see if we press and hold, it's sort of slow. If we go to fast, it's much more like 3D touch. So I would recommend switching that to fast. With previous versions of iOS, when you went to add a link to an email message, you have to add the entire link. So if we press and hold, paste a link, you'll see it adds the link and adds those visuals. However, if you don't want that, with iOS 17, they've actually updated it. So we can add a link to a word. If I press and hold on the word here, we'll try and select it here. Sometimes it's a bit buggy. We'll select, there we go. We can add a link once you've selected it. So tap on add a link, then paste your link here, and then tap return. And now it's just linked to the word. Tap on it and it will open up if you actually send this. So now it's linked directly to that word instead of actually being a full pasted link that you saw before with sort of the overall visuals from it. If you want to do that, that's available now. Also, when you're selecting text, the magnifier has been updated. I'm not sure if you use this a lot, but it makes it much easier to use compared to what it was before. So before, the magnifier was very small. I really appreciate that update in iOS 17. There's a couple things I wanted to share with Safari as well. If we go into Safari and maybe we go to our tabs, open a private tab, and maybe we want to use Apple, or maybe we want to search. Everything defaults to one specific search engine, such as Google. With iOS 17, you can change that. If we go into our settings, scroll down until we get to Safari. Within Safari, you'll see search engine. If we turn off the feature below it where it says also use in private browsing, disable that, we'll now have the option to change it to a search engine of our choice, whether that be DuckDuckGo, Bing, Yahoo, or Ecosia. So we can use any one of those. And when we go into Safari, now within private browsing, we can look for Apple, search for it, and it will use DuckDuckGo. If I go back to my regular tab here, that's not private browsing, search for Apple, this will use Google. So it switches automatically between each one of those. Also, when you're sharing a link in Safari, sometimes there's a bunch of tracking links involved, maybe a long string of code that's at the end of the URL, and you don't want it to do that every time. You just want to share the link itself. If you want it to take that off automatically, you can do that by going into your settings. Again, under Safari settings, scroll to the bottom, go to advanced, and you'll see under privacy, it says advanced tracking and fingerprinting protection. Tap on this, and by default, it's typically on private browsing. If you switch it to all browsing, it will remove some of that tracking information every time you share that. So it makes it a little bit more secure if you want to do that. So pretty simple option. And so those are some things I think many people have forgotten are in iOS 17 and are really helpful if you haven't enabled some of those features or you just weren't aware some of them were there. Let me know your most used feature in iOS 17 or maybe some tips that you've had as well that maybe you've found while using it along the way. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do, and be sure to check out NordPass in the description below, and thanks to them for sponsoring this video again. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.